And so so when I was arranging this tune, it comes from that era, so I thought, well, I have to pay tribute to it. So listen, and you might be able to hear a certain section that's very much a tribute to that style of music. So I want to bring Greg Diarra onto the stage. Give it up for the vibe master. Greg to bring the vibe, because I met this guy when I was studying at ASU, and he's incredible. So without further ado, the Sam Cooke composition.
Thank you.
So, change is going to come, but with a little bit of this. So, thank you to the Miracles for making my time here. It's so incredible. Really appreciate it. This next tune is going to feature the artistry of Matt and Sean. We're all going to play a trio tune by Joey Calderazzo entitled The Oracle. I used to live in Tucson with my family, and I had an awesome opportunity to go see the Branford Rosales Quartet perform. And I was actually able to go backstage and talk with Joey Calderazzo, who plays in that group. And I was, in high school. I was like early high school at the time, maybe even middle school. So I had no idea who this guy was. I was like, oh, cool, piano player. He was really good. This guy is like a heavyweight in the jazz world, and I've come to really love his playing and what he does with the Branford Marsalis Quartet. And he comes from the lineage of this piano-saxophone pairing, sort of this Coltrane, Coy Tyner, Branford Marsalis, Joey Calderazzo sort of approach that my professor, Mike Coker, and my other teacher, Matt Williams, have really opened that world up to me, and it's become something that's a really important part of my playing. So this next tune is sort of my tribute to that history of McCoy Tyner, Joey, what they've done for the art form, and who's moving it forward now. So I hope you enjoy The Oracle by Joey Calderazzo. everybody has a couple songs or an album that means something really special to them. You discover it by the oddest of circumstances. My dad loves Abbey Road. It's like his favorite album of all time. My girlfriend's dad loves Stephen Sondheim's Send the Clowns. Sean Brogan really likes the Sex and the City theme song. We all have these songs that are really important to us. It's true, trust me. We play it every Thursday. I was in a combo with Mike Coker and along the sax player, they knew a little bit, and a couple of the guys in the jazz program, and we learned this song called Fallen Grace by ear. So that's kind of intense, because Mike just sat down at the piano and was like, okay, here's the melody, and it's like this really weird melody that doesn't sound like it's in 16 measures, but it is. And so we had to learn how to sing that, and then we had to sing the bass line. So it was like insanely difficult, and became one of my most favorite tunes of all time. It's just one of those songs that really resonates with me. And so I thought, well, I should share it with you individually, so I'm going to perform it for you as a solo piano piece. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy Falling Grace by Steve Swallow.
Thank you.
McCaslin, whoever I need to come back on stage. You're back. Matt McClintock, Rich Kniss, and Sean Brogan. Thanksgiving is soon upon us. Turkeys back in our hall. Mashed potatoes and gravy and stuffing. And so I thought, what better way than to celebrate all of you with a bluegrass tune called Turkey in the Straw. So we're going to play that for you now. And it's going to be a hoot and holler. Please feel free to make as much noise as possible. You actually play better when you make more noise during a song like this. Not like the human noise right now, which would you, but during this, feel free to hoot and holler if you hear something that you like. So, Turkey in the Straw.
Thank you.
the next tune. Give it up for Alon. Contemporary jazz is something that's happening right now. That's the jazz that's happening in New York today, tonight, while we're doing this, something's happening over there. There's this composer out there named McCaslin. He teaches at a couple different universities, New England Conservatory being one of them. He came and visited ASU one time. I play at the W Scottsdale Hotel with Sean Brogan every Thursday, a drummer by the name of Nico Rocco, who I think is here, actually, got me that gig. It was my first study that I've ever had as a musician. I've learned a lot, and I've met a lot of musicians through that. It's been incredible. So Nick left to pursue dreams in California, and we got a new drummer by the name of Emerson. And he and I were talking about this album that Donny McCaslin came out with. I checked it out like sophomore year. I listened to the whole thing. I was like, I'm going to sit down and listen to this. This is like the new music that's happening right now. I listened to it all the way through, and I hated it. I was like, that is horrible. How can that even be considered music? This is noise. And then Emerson and I were talking about it, and I think this was like end of junior year, and I get another listen to it, and I was like, oh my god, this is the best thing ever. So it's amazing how things change over time and how tastes change. And so I thought that this would be a great tune to reflect that part of the journey of a musician over time in this recital. So this song is named Detention by Donny McCaslin. I hope you enjoy trying to figure out what time signature it's in, what meter it's in, what the hits are, trying to anticipate anything like that. It's a really fun tune. It's been a great time putting together. So here's Tension by Donny McCaslin. Thank you.
Thank you.
to accompany this. So thank you so much. I'll see you on the North Patio.